Hey everyone, Rob WiseGuy82 here. Very special video. Just hit 250 subs finally. That is freaking amazing. Thank you guys so much. I can't freaking believe it. That's crazy. Definitely feels awesome, humbling. Biggie just hit his, he's passed it now, well past it, 500. Freaking amazing. Man, it's so cool. So, great feeling. Great to see tons and tons of new people in here. I just had my 1 year anniversary on YouTube. I totally missed it by like a week and a half or so. So that made a video a few weeks back talking about how it was either that I'm obviously just going to wait until 250. It took some time. It was back and forth for a while there. That was funny, but awesome, man. Thank you guys so much. So this will be kind of a long video. Hopefully you guys will stick it out. I've got some cool stuff that I'm going to show you. I've got Christian Collins. I'm 99% sure that you were my 250th sub, and I just checked out a little bit of your channel. I didn't watch any videos, but I just scrolled through some of it and subbed. I'm going to try to see if it looks like you got some awesome stuff and got a lot of the same taste, it looks like. So I'm going to see if maybe I don't have anything that I can add to your collection a little bit, because that's awesome, man. So, like I said, I'm 99% sure that it was you. So,
I'll double-check that. Thank you so much for that, brother. And then I'm going to show you guys some of my favorite CGC books. I'll talk about, what got me started and things like that. Some cool little milestones that I call them milestones. But I've got some good beer. I know not everybody does. I love good pot. So I got some good pot here, some of my favorite. It's probably really reminiscent of like a sour diesel type. I'm not going to show it because I thought about it because it's super freaking green and sticky and awesome. But I saw some videos, and the people that do it, they live in the States where it's recreationally legal. But fuck, man, I know they're growing it down the street for medical use here. And I believe it's Xerox has a warehouse or something, or Kodak, something like that. We're going to try this. I just picked it up. We're going to use this great little tobacco pipe. Let's see. Get off camera. Ooh, that's super tasty. Awesome. And then I got right here, this is Dogfish Head. This is the 90 minute. The 90 minute IPA. And then it is 9% ABV. This is a fucking fantastic beer. I love it. Yep.
That's good. Pretty clear. Ooh. Yeah, that's a strong one.
All right, so been a year, it was August 3rd, I think it was August 3rd that I made my fifth video in 2015, and then in April, I bought my first comic or graphic novel or anything of the sort. Was, it was in April of some time, and that was, Batman, The Long Halloween. This is the graphic novel, and this is the one that I got. I know it's not a big deal. It's not like a first print or anything, but The Long Halloween. Oh, son of a bitch. Okay. All that was for was because, like, months, like, a, maybe like four or five, well, I'd have to look at the videos. I don't know. It was a while later. I came across all the single issues, the 13 single issues, and
I found them all at the same place. They're all gorgeous condition, and I got them all. The most expensive, the most I paid for any one of them was for the first issue and the last issue, and that was $6. The rest I paid $4 for, and they are gorgeous condition. I don't know. Some of them are, they've got a couple of ticks in them, but awesome. So yeah, about a year and 4 months now, I've been collecting and reading comics, and it all started with working at this dealership and talking with my boss about the, it was either right before or right after Age of Ultron came out, and I was talking about how Tony Stark is the one that created him with the Jarvis AI and whatever, you know, however it happened in the movie. So he's looking at me like I've got three eyes, because he doesn't watch those movies. He's a comic fan from back in the day, like a lot of you guys are. 40 years he's been collecting comics, so he starts telling me how it really happened with Hank Pym and Pym Particles and all these awesome and amazing stories. And I started doing my own research. I started going to YouTube, looking up other videos about them, and top, you know, what are the top 10 books to get you started in reading comics or graphic novels. And a lot of your guys' videos, like one of the first ones, I think, are like, man, I mean, he's not here anymore, and there was a lot of drama, but We Love Comics, that was one of the first ones. But even, I'm trying to think, because Big E's came out in October, and that was just 2 months after me, so I know I've been subbed to him since pretty much the beginning. Don, Comic Book Junkie, Merc with a Mouth, like Jimmy C, man, there's a lot of them. Now I'm drawing blanks. I didn't even write any shout-outs down. Sorry about that, guys. But there's a few of them. So, a lot of those were some of the ones that I was watching, and like people that put top 10 lists out, like I was saying, for best books. And this was definitely on one of them. So, I was in Barnes & Noble. I love going in there, putzing around, and happened to come across this. I bought it. I read it that same night, cover to cover. Absolutely amazing. And then it was completely off to the races, like you guys have seen. Absolutely crazy. You might as well say that, you know, anybody who falls in love, you know, like you do for the first time with something, you might as well say that instead of having a savings account, I've got my savings account around me. So if anything happens, because I definitely have some stuff that has, it's got a hell of a lot of potential. So that's my, yeah, that was my first Batman The Long Halloween. It was my very first one I read. And then I got the second one, and it's right there, is Kingdom Come. The third graphic novel I read, because I still wasn't picking up any single issues. I didn't for about a month. Maybe three weeks or so. And then Civil War, The Killing Joke. And then Wolverine was my favorite character from back in the day, even though I never read comics or anything when I was younger. But I always knew about him. I watched the Saturday morning cartoons. And Wolverine was always my favorite. So Old Man Logan, and then The Death of Wolverine. And then, oh, you know, in there I bought my first Walking Dead hardcover. And then I think right around there is when I started picking up single issues, like Postal was one of the first ones that I got onto. Yeah, like Postal, Autumnlands, Birthright, Black Magic, Descender, Deadly Class, East of West, Lazarus, you know, all of those, like, you know, The Walking Dead, Nailbiter, that was another one, Outcast, all those were just a few issues in when I started. But Postal was the very first one that I picked up from my local LCS. Oh, yeah, and in there, too, I was, it's, And I've got it. It's awesome. And I know it's not like I bought it 40 years ago and I still got it. I don't know why I said that. But, yeah, those were some of the first titles that I got pretty much from the beginning. The ones like Saga, East of West, they were, had to have been, what, three trades in? Well, Saga's a little bit further along than East of West is, but, so I think for East of West, it was the third. Yeah, because I've got three, I got the three, and then I jumped on it from there, and then I've got four of Saga, and then I jumped on it from there. And then Rachel Rising, all those two. Awesome, freaking amazing books. That one's now over. Revival is one of my favorites. Ooh. Cowboy Ninja Viking. I know Don, Comic Book Junkie, I believe it was him and Skyler has picked those up in the past year or so. That, Riley Rossmo is one of my favorite artists, and that was my first taste of excuse me. That was Bedlam.
And I will show you guys a good segue to my very first CGC book that I ever got. And this is Bedlam number one. This is the, the Third Eye. You can see the guy right there. Third Eye Comics variant. And this is signed by Nick Spencer. Sorry for the glare. Nick Spencer. And then signed... It's signed in purple. It's kind of hard to see it. Sorry. But you can see it. It's signed with a sketch, just a quick little BS sketch of Matter Red. That's the main crazy psycho villain in this. Badass, crazy serial killer. So signed by Riley Rossmo. He's got a cool signature. So this was the very first, and I picked it up for like $28. Fucking amazing. Let's see. Where should I put these when I'm done? We're going to be scattered a little bit too. I'll start talking about something and then get sidetracked. What can I talk about now? So we were talking about Bedlam. Oh, we were talking about Riley Rossmo and Cowboy Ninja Viking. See, that's what we were doing. So, yeah. And then it's just been off to the races. I love the Independence is probably... Those are my favorite books. Small press. Really limited books that are limited to hundreds of copies or 1,000 copies. Those are my favorite stuff to... That's my favorite stuff to get. Some of the more recent books, some of my favorite stuff is like Black Magic with Rucka and Nicola Scott. Nicola Scott is a goddess. Some of my other favorite artists are Jenny Frison and... not going to sit here and do the game. Let's see. Yeah. Nick Dragato, who's doing East of West, is amazing. And Matteo Scalera, who does Black Science. Art Germ, that's Stanley Lau. But Gabriel Delato is my absolute favorite. Number one. Absolute number one. If you guys haven't jumped on to Monstrous, the first story arc just ended, it's 1-6. Absolutely freaking stunning, gorgeous, should be award-winning. Absolutely award-winning. But Sana Takeda does the art for that, and Marjorie Lau does the story, and it is just a gorgeous... It could not be a more perfect team-up for that book. Eddie Granoff, Adam Hughes, Jock... I already said Jenny Frison, but Ben Oliver is one of the more recent ones that I've, and he's a painter too. He did a kick-ass, and I haven't got him, but I will. It's Batman, All-Star Batman number one, Harley Quinn number one, and then Suicide Squad number one. And it's a really close, like, boop in your face like this, and then white all around it with the title of Batman, Harley, and then Killer Croc is who it is for Suicide Squad. So that was really cool. So, I don't know about you guys, but in looking for some of the more rare books, and that's another thing I do when I'm on eBay. I get very specific in my searches, like, I'll put in hard-to-find Image Comics or hard-to-find
small press books, and I'll get very specific in what I'm looking for, and or just put in rare comics, or you know, even what else is really cool is like the what's the word I'm looking for, the retracted or the error comics, like I've got the one where I forget exactly which one it is, but it's a Wolverine book where it says Kike in it, and they, what the fuck is that word, not retracted.
That's fucking hilarious. But anyway, so I came, I didn't search out these opportunities, but I've been, I would definitely say blessed with some very cool, unique opportunities to have some one-of-a-kind books. And one of my prized possessions in my collection, and I say this every time, this is not going to be for everybody, this is not a series for everybody, this is a very graphic, very brutal, very dark series, but it's, I think it's amazing. And I am literally, and I would love to know if, you know, that's one thing that I'm going to do is a contest for my 250 subs, and I'm trying to think of something to do. I'll be thinking of something to do for it, and I'll talk about that in a little bit as well. Does anybody else have any literally one-of-a-kind things that have been, you know, that have been published? So, and I'll show you what I mean here. This is Crossed Plus 100, CGC numbered edition, 1 through 6, and this is the Alan Moore run, so everybody knows Alan Moore. Now, this is Crossed Plus 100. Garth Ennis is the one who came up with Crossed back in 2008, I believe. Did the first 9 issues, and then many other people have taken the helm since then. Some notable writers are Simon Spurrier, Jeff Lapham, who does 20, Stray Bullets, Jeremy? No, Jeff. Well, whatever, you guys know. But, so this one right here is Alan Moore came up with Crossed Plus 100, and this is 100 years after the Crossed outbreak. And Gabriel Andrade does the cover and art. So I got the first one that I picked up was it came with 2 books. It was the Taste Test right here, and the Cross. You get a mark like this, and it goes like right under your eyes right here, and it's like it's eating away at your flesh. So it's just like burned into you, and it brings out all of your. It's insane. It's crazy. Basically turns you into a primal Neanderthal. All it is murder, sex, rape. It's fucking crazy when you get this. They're basically like, Crossed is a genre of zombie book, you would say, or end of the world, apocalypse book, but not holding anything back. You will see people torn apart. You will see every horrible aspect of human nature explored in this book. But if there really was something like this, this is exactly how it would be. Very amazing, very different each volume, because they have different writers and artists that get on it. But it's not for everybody, like I said, but I can appreciate it. I don't know, I like it. So this right here is extra special because the first one I got, if you can see, guys, CGC numbered edition, limited to 250. This is the Taste Test. These are all 9.8s, and it was not guaranteed that I was supposed to get this. So, or it was not guaranteed that I was going to get this. So that was the Taste Test, and this is number 1. I'll move it around, you guys will see the whole thing eventually, so. But, so this is the Taste Test, they're all very gruesome, you can see this guy's got a head right here, and it's hard to, damn, man, maybe you guys don't even want to know, but somebody over here is, stretching a person's face over a guitar, somebody's making, I think like a flute or something out of bones, so it's not very wholesome, I know, it's gross. But, whatever. So this one right here is
the taste test in this, and it was, these were both the same, these are, because they're the numbered edition. Can you see that? My number is 41. So number 41 out of 250.
And this was a special thing that they did with CGC, so each one that, each one, it came out one at a time, that's why it wasn't guaranteed. I didn't even get there yet. So I bought these two initially, and then when I was putting my order in for number two, I get an email saying, because I had ordered many things from, and this is Comics Cavalcade. So when I was putting in my order for number two, we've got a couple of Elvises beating the shit out of each other, and you can see this guy's face right here, the crossed. I got an email one day saying, you know, we can, you know, we really appreciate you obviously getting all these books from us, and we don't do this for everybody, they were saying, but it's possible, but not guaranteed, that we could, because they come out, you know, they come out one at a time after each one comes out. But if number 41 for each book, if it comes out to be a 9.8, they said that they would hold that number for me. But like I said, it's not guaranteed. So it took me about 8 months, 8 or 9 months to get this set, one at a time. And sometimes they had to hold it for, you know, a few weeks or a month for me to gather up the money. And, sure enough, one after the other, every one of them came back a 9.8,
and nobody else in the world can have this unless I sell it. Number 41. This is number 3, and again, I apologize for the glare. See a bunch of heads on a compound, and it's crazy. There's a crow on top right there, but number 41. And the other thing,
so yeah, number 2 was limited to 250 as well. But the other thing is that they start going down in number. If you guys can see right here,
this one is number 41 out of 150.
And then the thing that makes this set even more rare is that number 6... is limited to only 100 copies. So, if you think about it like this, guys, only 100 complete sets of 1 through 6 can exist, even though there's 250 copies of the taste test, or issue 0, 1, 2, issue 0, 1, and 2, so the first three. The very last issue, and that's the only one, because this is number 4. It's a group of regular folks who have caught a crossed individual and are exacting their pound of flesh. But again, number 41 out of 150. 9.8. And then this is number 5 out of 150.
Or number 5, and there's only 150 of these made. Number 41. CGC 9.8. Again, it was meant to be, you know, one after the other, these books just came out.
And each one of them were, they made it, because, you know, my set, think about it, guys, my set is screwed if one of these number 41s gets damaged. So this right here is the reason that, and then how many people bought these and then got a different number if they bought number 2? So, what would you guys think? Maybe a quarter? Maybe 25 sets? Somebody actually thought, hey, or maybe they only offered to 25 people? I can't believe that it would be any more than that.
So, I mean, I would love to know if anybody has anything similar to this. I don't know why. This way, that way doesn't do anything for us. I don't know why. Or I don't know what I was saying, whatever, I forgot. But anyways, guys, that's so funny. Number 41, number 6, it
baffles me that I was able to have this, and I didn't go looking for it. Somebody was awesome enough to offer it. So this was like kind of one of the really cool milestones in collecting. You know, you want something that nobody else in the world can have. So another cool one happened not too long ago. And, 25 minutes. So this right here is the Beauty number 9. And I showed the other cover before, but this is cover B, I believe. Let me see. Yep, 921. And you can always tell by the barcode. 00921. 9 is because this is the 9th issue. There we go. Sorry about that, guys. 9 because it's the 9th issue. 2 is because this is cover B. Cover B. So if it was cover C, then that would be a 3. And then, for instance, this Bedlam Third Eye variant. On the back of this, because this is the first issue, it says 001. If you can see it, 4, because this is the fourth cover. And then 1, because it's the first print. The very last number indicates the first print. 1. Okay? So this right here is another milestone, or what I would consider a milestone for this hobby, collecting. You know, maybe having your name part of a book. Being part of a book. So here we go, guys. So this is kind of my little... I did this for a little shout-out for our community. There I am, guys. Rob WiseGuy82. This is my little ass-kissing I did for them, and their really cool response from, Jeremy did that, I think? Yep, he's the one, him or his wife was the one who did that. So that's an awesome little milestone, actually, having one of my little letters in the letter column. Absolutely amazing. Here's something. Yeah, I almost forgot about this, guys. Jeez. I don't show too many pops. So some of my favorite pops, guys. This is my last one that I got because I love Doctor Strange. And I'll tell you some little stuff, too, about me because I'm debating. I know a lot of people have been doing some artwork lately. We've got Tat from Tat Comics and Eddie the Comic Guy who has sent a bunch of drawings to people. And I think it's Louis Jewell who did a really cool piece for Don Comic Junkie. But I haven't done anything in a long time, and it's kind of, art is emotional, right? So we do it in, sometimes to release things, and it's been a really long time since I've done any kind of art, but I went to, I took some classes at the local college here, figure drawing classes, and some pastels, and charcoals, and things like that. Maybe I'll, show a couple things at the end. I don't know how long I plan on doing this video. I don't even know how long you guys are going to stick with me. But, so this right here, is one of my favorite ones because if you guys can, you guys can see right here, the way he has his hands right here, ever since I was, five, whenever, because it was just me and my mom growing up, parents divorced when I was 2, dad's always been in Texas, that was where I did some of my videos with you guys. Just been me and my mom the whole time. So whenever we say goodbye, we've never not done this to each other. So that right here is the reason why this is probably one of my absolute favorite pops. But Doctor Strange is one of my favorite Marvel characters too. And then I love horror. Silence of the Lambs is one of my favorite horror movies. But Mads Mikkelsen is one of my favorite actors who has done Hannibal. And this is the Wendigo that, if you've seen the show, you know. But I can't get enough, and I was really upset when that got canceled because that was a gorgeously horrific show. That's a good way to put that. These are a couple that I don't know if I've seen anybody put up. But, I freaking love this movie. I don't know about you guys, but The Nightmare Before Christmas. Now, these are extra special, guys, because these are the Day of the Dead, Jack, Skellington, and Sally. And I love, look at the design on them, guys.
straight on the box, just them. And then look at Sally. Sally looks freaking awesome. I love their faces. Look at that. Absolutely awesome. And they're together. But these are freaking amazing. I love, there's a lot of like Lady Mechanica variant covers that have Lady Mechanica done up with the skull. So these are a couple of my favorite ones too. And then my favorite Wolverine. This is the original one, I believe, the 05. I don't have any of the other ones, but I've got a few pops. I think I've got like 20 of them. But this was my this was one of my first ones, I think. And then I really love, and I think there's something obviously very special about Heath Ledger's portrayal of Joker. There he is on the back right there. So I had to have this pop. Yeah, man, that's just tragedy, but something, again, horrific, crazy, special about that, knowing, when you watch that, knowing that that's his, you know, he died when he was making it. It's, and some of the things that we've heard around it, all the drugs that he was taking or whatever, so very interesting stuff. That's one of my favorites, so that performance should go down in history. And then another thing, guys, you check out my shirt. Starry Night is one of my favorite paintings ever. And then you've got Batman put into it. Awesome. Alright, so. Oh, jeez. This is actually probably, this got to be one of my favorites too. Top five. Remember when we lost Brandon Lee in 1993, making the Crow. This is the special glow-in-the-dark Hot Topic exclusive. I had to have this. I think I paid like $25 or so for this. All the rest were just like 8 to 12, whatever they normally are. But that was probably my first big, you know, death that really hit me. Because what was I, 11? I was born in 1982. But yeah, this is one of my favorite pops too. So what else can we talk about, guys? I mean, we're going on 33 minutes here, so, or over 33 minutes. And I know because, there's a lot of new people on here. I want to show some stuff that I haven't showed in a while. This right here I'll show you guys is my very first commission sketch. Because I have some sketches that I've bought on eBay or whatever, and this is my very first one that I've actually, I haven't looked at it in a while, but you may be able to still get these. It's Comics Tribe. This is a really crazy, book in the vein of Seven, the movie Seven. This is Oxymoron, The Loveliest Nightmare. The main character in that is the character of Oxymoron. And this is him in the middle right here. Now, these other characters we saw, that other little sketch on Bedlam. This is Matter Red. And then, of course, we've got the Joker here. This, if you can see, guys, basically what I did was, or what you could do is pay. There were some sketches that were already done by the artist Alex Cormick. And you can see there's his signature right here. Done last year. There were some that were already done that were, say, $40, but then for, I think it was $59, I think it was, you could tell him, if you had an idea of something. So basically, at the point that I had gotten this done, some of my favorite characters were, I've always loved the Joker since Jack Nicholson, and like I was talking about Heath Ledger. But since I had been reading comics, my new favorite crazy psycho villains that absolutely are in the vein of Joker. So if you guys have not read Bedlam or Oxymoron, these characters are 100% in the vein of Joker. So basically what I told them, because this is Oxymoron, The Loveliest Nightmare, I want the Joker and Matter Red breaking into an insane asylum to free Oxymoron, and what we see is them getting to him and breaking him, or trying to get him out of his straitjacket. You could see Joker's, they're both looking down and trying to undo his straitjacket. But, so it's basically a black and white cover with blood splattered everywhere, and it's hard to tell, but it looks like there's ash or stuff floating, and then there's like smoke and everything in the background. That's like maybe they shot a bazooka into the side to create the hole to get a new. But guys, this is a, so you can see the Joker, and then this is a wraparound cover. So there's the rest of them. There's not much on the wraparound, but there's the Joker's arm right here, and then all the smoke. But you can see, it's tough to tell, but all the little white dots, they're all like rays. So if it wasn't in the top loader, you could feel it's like you just globbed paint or something on it. But look at how crazy that is, guys. So these are like the most vicious villains in comic books right now. So you've got the Joker, Matter Red, and so it's DC, which is the biggest company out of the three. You've got Image Comics, which is the biggest independent, and then Comics Tribe, which is a little teeny company, and that's where Oxymoron came from. And his first appearance is in a book called The Red Ten, which is about Oxymoron killing the 10 superheroes that are in the U.S. or something like that. It's I haven't been able to find that, but this is the second volume. I've been able to come across the first hardcover, but I haven't been able to come across the rest of them. But this is the second volume. This is called The Loveliest Nightmare. I believe it was 4 issues, and there is going to be more. But so this is my very first commission sketch, and it is a, like I said, guys, you heard me, $59.99 plus like $5 shipping. And so that's what I told him, and this is what he came up with, this insane, absolutely cover-to-cover, crazy freaking wraparound sketch. Absolutely unbelievable.
Some of my other favorites, guys, I'll show you.
This is my Outcast 9.8. The only thing that sucks about this is that it's that huge case. I'll get it redone, but you could see the, what is that acid paper or whatever that, or I don't know what it's called, but that kind of slipped out of the bottom. But that's my Outcast 9.8. This is one that I hope is not the book that I have to wait forever on. And because it was like Jonathan Hickman came out with this, I believe it was 2013 or 14. And then he came out with like the issue 2 months later. This is The Dying and the Dead. Sorry, guys. Ryan Bodenheim is the artist, and he does the cover art. But Jonathan Hickman, Dying and the Dead. 3 issues have come out in like 2 or 3 years. He said we were going to get more, like, I think it was like almost a year or 6 months or so between issues 2 and 3. But then they said they were going to, I don't know if they were going to start it over, or I don't know how they were going to do it, but hopefully this isn't the one that we have to wait 5 years in between. But this is, I definitely want this story to be finished. Dying and the Dead. I think he actually started doing this around the same time as, or maybe a little bit after, East of West. And I definitely enjoyed it. I got the same feeling when I read this as I did when I first read East of West. So that's one of my favorites. I don't even know how many people are still with me at this point. I mentioned Autumn Lands was one of the first books that I ever got. It started off being Tooth and Claw, but this is a special one, guys. This is the sketch cover. There's only 500 of these, I believe. But this is signed by Kurt Busiek and Benjamin Dewey. But it's also sketched by Benjamin Dewey with one of the main characters. What is her name? Garta. She's a warthog. That's this person right here in the middle. But so there's only 500 of these, and then this is signed and sketched by the artist and signed by Kurt Busiek. Oh, sorry, 9.8 signature series. It's actually absolutely amazing. this story is freaking phenomenal. Any pitching stories for Commandy. All of them got denied. Years later, this is, I guess, what he had pitched. So I thought that was pretty cool.
This right here, Matt Kent is one of my favorite writers going on right now.
He's doing Department H, and he's also doing the 4001 AD storyline for Valiant. But this is Mind Management. He came out with this, I believe. It was in like 2012 or 2013. 40-issue series, I believe, and then there was one more afterwards. But this is, I don't know how many they did of this, guys, but this is from Dark Horse. But this is the variant cover. That's all it says is variant cover. Yeah, 1-2-1 is how it is on the back. But then, it, again, signature series. It's kind of hard to see, guys, but it's signed right there by Matt Kent. 9.6. You got it for like $40, guys. What the hell is that? But this is the variant cover. There's definitely not too many of these around. And, you know, the reason I had to jump on it was because, you know, I said I got it for $40. But at the time I had gotten this, these were going for, you would have to pay that much for a raw copy. And not even a perfect one or a near mint one. So they were going anywhere from like $50 or $100. But someone let me have this one for $40.
Oh, this is another one.
Revival. This is the, it just says variant cover again, but this is the blue variant is how I see it described on eBay. Got this for like $35. It is, well, 35 plus shipping, I think is what it was. So maybe about 40. But this one is signed by Tim Seeley. Right there. A little hard to tell. Right by the scythe. But not a lot of these around either, and these are pretty damn expensive. Again, I paid pretty much less than what you're going to pay for a raw copy for this. I got this a while ago. Most of these I got quite a while ago, at least a year ago. But, yeah, this is one of my favorites.
Yeah. And then the last thing, I guess, you know, I mentioned I'm going to do a contest for my 250 subscribers, and the only reason I'm giving this up is because I was able to get a better copy. But this was kind of it's a grail, because it's a pre-grail grail, right? So this is Wolverine number one. This is a PGX 8.0. I paid $55 for it, I think. 45 or 55. But yeah, I got, this was one of the first, I think this is one of the first five PG, first five books, slab books that I was able to get. But, I got this because this is the very first solo Wolverine, done in 1982, September of 1982, and that's the year I was born, except I was born in February. So yeah, this is Wolverine number one, Frank Miller cover and art, Joe Rubenstein on art as well, and then Chris Claremont's story. But this is the book that I, this is my pre, this is, what the hell am I trying to say? Sorry guys. Hulk 181 is my grail. This is was my grail before that, so this is as close as I can get right now to my Hulk 180 and then the 181. But for me, guys, I want that 180 first, because I gotta have that awesome, I gotta have that sketch of by Herb Trimpe with Wolverine coming through, that very first one. That's the one that I gotta have. So once I come up with this, I'll try to do it in the next week. Once I come up with a contest, this I think is gonna be my first place prize. And the only reason I'm willing to give it up, guys, is because the book that I got it replaced with, and this is my crazy full of signatures and sketches, really hard to see, but so I mean, it's signed by Stan Lee, even though he doesn't have any business being on this book,
but it's also signed, so Stanley is here, right here, but then Len Wein, one of the creators of Wolverine, is here, and then Herb Trimp is across the eyes right here, but also Herb Trimp, look at da-da, badass original Wolverine sketch. Totally looks like the Wolverine from Hulk 180, that first little panel that he did with the lines. But then, where is it? Rubenstein, Joe Rubenstein is right here going up one of the claws, right next to the sketch. And then Luis Simonson is going right across his finger saying, come here. Luis Simonson. So this is signed by five of them. Now the only people missing from this is Frank Miller and Chris Claremont. Now, I don't know. I mean, so obviously, so, oh, this is a, Signature Series 9.6. And you can see, like, this was all done. I didn't get any of these guys, so I bought this. I found it on eBay. But it was done at different points. So what I think, you know, I got to get, like I said, I got to get Frank Miller, and I know he's expensive as shit. I got to get Frank Miller and Chris Claremont to sign this book, and I'm pretty sure, unless you guys know otherwise, those are the last two that I need for being a creator or a writer or artist on the book. So I don't know, man. If anybody can help me out, I don't know the process. Obviously, they got to unslab it, take it to him, re-slab it. I don't know. So that's the only reason why I'm willing to give this book right here. This is, again, a PG8 8.0. Looks really good. It's a little bit wavy. It was done in 2013, so it's going on 4 years old. It could definitely go for an upgrade on the case. But, fuck, awesome. So, this is at least going to be one of the prizes, and I'm going to go through a bunch of stuff and try to come up with something. I'm getting anxiety over this, guys, because I love these freaking books. And I don't necessarily, a lot of the books that I get are really rare, so I don't have the opportunity to get more than one of them. So a lot of times when I do give things up, I have multiple copies. So I know a lot of us are like that. But okay, so the last thing, like I said, I guess what I'll do, guys, is I'll show you some of my artwork that I've done. I haven't done anything in a super long time. It's been 7 years, 6 or 7 years since I did these. But give me a second, guys. Let me grab them. So, one of the things I did was a figure drawing class. So these right here, what we would do is like 5, 10, 20 minute sketches, like they would get into a pose. And you can see right here, guys, this is a 20 minute pastel. So I don't know how good you're going to be able to see this, guys. But it's done with like greens and blues. You know, and if you guys are, if anybody has ever gone to a figure drawing class, you better not expect models. Alright, guys? It's going to be average people like you and me. And I'll tell you one crazy thing that happened was one guy, I think he was like 67 or 68, came, very well dressed, button-down shirt, tie, nice coat. Damn it if he didn't have a humongous Prince Albert, a giant gauged ring. And he had gotten that for his wife, who had ovarian cancer, I believe, or something like that. So that was his story. That was pretty freaking awesome. But so this other cool thing that happened when I was in one of the other, it was one of my charcoal classes, was we actually got a real human skeleton. And we got to pose her in the way that we wanted. And this is what me and a group of people came up with. and we all got in a circle around it and just drew. This was the angle that I got.
So again, hopefully. And these are done on, what is it?
And this was a real skeleton, real person.
Oh. That was just the empty bottle, don't worry.
This was, you know, one of like the, what do they call it, forced perspective, where they just set up a bunch of things. So you can get like the guitar in the back. This is like a water vase. This was like a yellow sheet that was just like a bunch of cloth. And this, if you could tell, is the letter E that was laid in there. Kind of hard to tell.
That was kind of cool.
This right here, I don't know if anybody's ever tried to draw an apple, especially one with pastels, but it's not easy. And a lot of these, man, the color has, I haven't kept these as well as I should, but it's hard as hell to draw an apple, guys. But I think, you know, when I was looking at these and I was like, damn, man, some of my favorite covers are the pastels and the watercolors. And, you know, that's what I love, man. And this right here, what we did was is had to put some tape on the apple in a 1-inch square and then draw inside that 1-inch square. So that's kind of, man, that was freaking tough. So that's kind of what I came up with. And that was for, you know, blending colors and getting tones and... So that was kind of cool. That came out pretty good, man. I like that. Let's see back here. It looks pretty good, right, guys? Eh, whatever. So let's see. Maybe one more. All right. All right, guys. So I don't know if I want to show you this one just because whatever. All right. So this, I'll save that one for last. This was a cool one. We just went outside and... this was one of the trees that were around the college. I think this one came out a lot better than I was thinking when I was doing it. Because I don't, you know, trees are not easy to draw. How can I show you like this? So there's a lot of different colors, if you can see. You know, like brown, but like purples and yellows because the sun was coming down on it. Can you see that? I don't know if you can see. Not the easiest stuff to draw. I think it probably looks better from back here. Well, maybe not. But this last one I'll show you guys is a self-portrait I did. My only, like, yeah, full finished self-portrait I've ever done. And this came out... I don't know, man. I feel like it came out a little wonky. I got one eye bigger than the other, but... Oh, yeah, and even on camera, it looks freaking retarded. It looks retarded! I don't know, whatever. And a lot of the depth, I think, has been, you know, rubbed out of it, because these are... this is just straight charcoal. But, you know, I feel like when I was doing it, it was a lot deeper in certain parts, and... Like the hair was, you could see that a little more detail in that, but it's definitely been just because of the way that I've kept them is, I haven't kept them as well as I should. I mean, you can see they're bent up and yeah, it's been probably 7 years they've been in just a bag. But so this is my, not perfect, but I don't know, my very first, and only, yeah, the eyes, man, it doesn't look right. Some aspects do, but, nah, it doesn't look right. Whatever. Maybe I'll try again someday. Holy crap, guys. Almost an hour.
All right. So, I guess that's it, guys.
I guess that's why I wanted to save that till the end, because I knew that I was going to get charcoal on me. But anybody who's stuck this far, you guys are awesome. Thank you so much. And again, this video was for you guys. Just wanted to tell you a little about myself and have a great beer with you, some great smoke, and show some great books and tell you a little bit about myself. So I will be coming up hopefully with a cool contest for everybody and come up with a few more cool prizes. So here's to another 250. Thank you guys so much. Shout outs to all my new subscribers. There's a lot of great new people out there. Rigor Mortis 86. Actually, what I'm going to do is a lot of names are pretty specific, so I'm not going to do any more shout outs in this video, especially because it's towards the end, but I'll write them down and I'll make sure I get the exact name, numbers, because I got numbers in mind. So anyways, longest video. So here's to the next 250, and thank you guys so much. Peace, love, and comics. God bless.